The Gemara says in Shabbos on Daf Kuf Lamed Gimel Lamed Beis regarding the mitzvah of milah, Hakol Amal, if one is in the middle of doing a circumcision, Kol Zman Shu Osek B'milah, as long as he's still involved in the circumcision. We know the different aspects to the mitzvah of milah. There is the milah, the act of cutting off the foreskin. There is the priya, the revealing of the membrane, and then there is the tuve damo, having some blood. So, whatever the definition, at least definitely we know malvolo para kilo mal. So clearly, if you haven't done the priya yet, that's still considered involved, and perhaps even the mitzit as well. So that's a discussion over there in the Gemara, in the Rishonim. But the halach is, the Gemara says, Calls Manchu Osek Bamila, Choser Ben Alasitzin Amaakvenes Amila, Uben Alasitzin She'ain Amaakvenes Amila. That the Gemara says, if you're still involved in doing the Bris Mila, so then it doesn't make a difference. There's different types of, when you make a cut for the Bris, there's the certain part of the skin that is imperative that it's cut off, and it's not cut off, you don't fulfill your mitzvah of milah. And there's other parts of the skin where it's part of hinder mitzvah, zek keilu anveo, you still fulfill the mitzvah, you just haven't done it in the best way. So the Gemara just says, if you're in the middle of the bris milah, and you remember that you still haven't done the sitzin she'ena ma'akvin, and the sitzin ma'akvin, you go back. Then pirish, what happens if I finish the bris? So then the Gemara says, I'll sitzin ama akvin es amila chozer. Then on the sitzin, on those skin that has to be cut, so then I have to go back. I'll sitzin she'ain ma akvin es amila eino chozer. But on the sitzin that are ma akvin, I don't go back. So that's the Gemara. Again, so the Gemara says, if you're involved in the Mila, so it doesn't make a difference if it's the Sitzin HaMa'akvin, the Sitzin which are an obstacle in performing the mitzvah, the Sitzin She'ein HaMa'akvin, either way, one has to go back. But Pirish, one finished the Bris, you finished the Bagel unlocked, so whatever the Bris is. So then it says, Sitzin HaMa'akvin, the ones that if you cut, you need to be cut more, so you have to go back. But if not, you don't go back. So what are we talking about? So Das HaTor, in Yoredeya Simin Reis Sadi Dawid, the Masha, when the Gemara says, Kishapirish, Eino Chozer Al Sitzin She'ena Ma'akvin, why wouldn't you go back? The Torah is bothered. Why wouldn't I go back on the Sitzin She'ena Ma'akvin? It's still Zek Keli Banveo, it's still Hid the Mitzvah. Why wouldn't I want to fulfill the Mitzvah? So the Torah says, because that's Tafka B'Shabbos. That Kevin She'pirish Gonasna Shabbos Kahatkos Eitzel Sitzin She'ena Ma'akvin. This aspect of Bris Milah, of Zek Keli Banveo, of Hid the Mitzvah, that isn't Docha Shabbos. So that's why you can't go back. And then presumably on Sunday you could finish off the job. So the Torah learns this whole brisa, which says you don't go back for the sitzin she'ena ma'akvin. That's only talking about on Shabbat, but during the week there's no reason in the world not to go back. However, Akdas Harambam, who from Beis Yosef, the Beis Yosef quotes the Shitas Harambam, who disagrees and says, Sha'af bechol eino chozer. So the Beis Yosef quotes the Rambam, a very interesting shita, very difficult to understand, that even during the week you can't go back on the Sitzin She'ena Ma'akvin. According to the Torah, you go back during the week, Shabbos, I can't because you're not on a Machal Shabbos. But what's the harm in going back? Like, why can't you go back? Why wouldn't you want the benefit of Hiddur Mitzvah? So there's a famous Beis HaLevi, Uver HaBeis HaLevi Bidas HaRambam, and the Beis HaLevi explains the Shita In the Das HaRambam, he explains what's the Pshat in the Rambam. The Hidr Mitzvah Shayach Rach Lomar, in other words, is a general Chakira by Hidr Mitzvah. In other words, Im Mitzvah Hidr, is it a general halacha, so as they call a kloli, that there's a mitzvah to do all the mitzvahs based on Zek Kelev and Veil in the optimal way? Oh, is that who Chaluk Miguf HaMitzvah? Or is Zek Kelev and Veil telling me that it's even in the aspect of the mitzvah that it's more like it becomes more inherent to the mitzvah, so we'll see. So, either way, the Beis HaLevi writes as follows. Bedas HaRambam Dehidu Mitzvah Shayach Omar Rach Bizman Kiyim HaMitzvah Shetebe Ofen Noel Mehuder. The only time it makes sense to do Hidr Mitzvah, the Rambam writes, Rambam holds Hidr Mitzvah doesn't make sense independently in a vacuum. It only makes sense if it's connected to the Maisa Mitzvah. It only makes sense if it's connected to the act of the Mitzvah. Masha'enkei Mamila, the Kevish Apirish, Mi Maisa Mila, Hare Kvar Nigma Maisa Mitzvah. Ve'en kem kishe yachtos achar kach hatzitzen she'en ma'akvin harehu misna beli kiyo mitzvah hu mishum she'en shayach hidda mitzvah achar shenigma mitzvah. The Rambam Shita is hidda mitzvah only makes sense in the context of the ma'isa mitzvah. So kol zman I'm involved in the mitzvah mila, so it makes sense to do the hidda mitzvah. But there's no value in doing Hidda Mitzvah after the Gemara Mitzvah. And therefore, the Rambam Shita is even during the week. I don't know if it's an Avera to do it. Maybe there's an Avera of Chabura causing harm or damage because it's not a Mitzvah. According to the Torah clearly learns Hidda Mitzvah makes sense independently, even in a vacuum, and even Perish, even if you go back. So on Chol, one is permitted and probably should go back and fulfill the mitzvah of Hidda Mitzvah. According to the Rambam, there is no fulfillment of Hidda Mitzvah. So if there is no mitzvah, then how could you do Chabur? That's the famous kasha they ask. How could Avram fulfill the mitzvah? By all mitzvahs, Avram, the Gemara says in Yuma, Dav Chav Ches, he was Makayim Kol HaTorah Kulo before it was commanded. So how come Mila, he was waiting for it? See, there are many answers. One answer is because before he's commanded a Mila, it would be us to do a Mila because you can't damage yourself. So therefore, same similar here. Once you finish the mitzvah of Mila, and there's no concept of Hidda Mitzvah after Acha Nigmar Mitzvasa, so therefore, that's the Rambam Shita. That the Machlokas, the Torah and the Rambam is, do you say Hidda Mitzvah independent, like the Torah says, and therefore even Perish Bechol, you could go back? Or the Rambam says, no, Ben Bechol, Ben Mitzvah, once you perish, once you finish the Mila, the mitzvah is nigmara, it's all over. And Lefiza Biar HaGriz, and that's what the Briska Rav points out. He wants to tie in this machlokas here between the Rambam and between the Tur. He wants to say it's the Rambam consistent with his view, Lugabe Nir Chanukah. What view is he referring to? So The Gemara in Shabbos on Daf Chaf Aleph Amud Beis talks about the three-tier obligation in the mitzvah of Ner Chanukah. Number one is Ner Ishu Beiso, one candle per household every night. That's the minimum obligation. Hamahadrin, those who are mahadir after mitzvahs. So if you have 10 people in your home, you light 10 candles every night. And Mahajan and Ahajan, according to the Rambam, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80 candles. So that's the Rambam Shita. And that's the way, as we'll see. So it's a Machokes. The way, what's Pshat when the Gemara says Mahajan and Ahajan according to Beis Hillel? That's the Pshat according to the Rambam. According to the Bali Tosfos, Mahajan is going back on Ner Ishu Beiso, and therefore it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You only have one menorah The Baal HaBayis lights one menorah for everybody, and according to the Minhag Ashkenaz, each person lights their own menorah. It's interesting here, usually the Sfardim follow the Rambam, and Ashkenaz follow the Baal HaTosfos. Here by Chanukah is reversed. So that's the Machlokes Rambam and Tosfos. Comes along the Briska Rav and says, according to the Rambam, HaBaal HaBayis Ma'aluch L'chol B'nei HaBayis, that when we say, according to Beisilah, Mahajim and Ahajin, you'll be lighting 80 candles the 8th night of Pesach, 8th night of Chanukah, if you have 10 members. HaBayis Ma'aluch L'chol B'nei HaBayis. He lights them all. Masha Amru, the Mahajin Ne'er L'chol Echad, Ein Perusho Shedra'al L'chol Echad B'nei Atzmo. The Rabbi doesn't want that each person lights their own. Ela Perusho Shabal Bayis Yosef Ne'er L'chol Echad, V'chulo Chada Hadlokah. There's only one lighting done by the Baal HaBayis. That's the Rambam Shita. Uam HaRama, the Rama writes in Hilchot Chanukah, Tav Reish Ayin, Hey, Sif Beis, Kasav, the Kol Echad Nei HaBayis Yailuk. Now, our custom, everyone lights their own candles, their own menorah. So what's in the Kudus HaMachlokis here between the Rambam and the Rama, whether one person lights for everybody, or everybody lights their own? So the Briska Rav explains as follows. Because of Hagriz Gover, the Rama Mazel Lishitason, the Rambam is consistent with his view, but Sitzin She'ein Ma'akvin Hamila, by Sitzin which are Ma'akvin as Hamila, the Ein Shayach Lazos Hidr Mitzvah, La'achash and Nigmar Mitzvah. What if the Rambam Shita by Tzitzin HaMa'akvin? Ben Mechol, Ben Meshavish, you can't go back. V'sover HaRambam, and the Rambam holds, V'kevin Nechol Ma'ashad Madlikin Ner L'chol Echa V'yechad, Hu Mishum Hidr Mitzvah. The Rambam writes, the first candle is Ner Ishu Beisa, that's one, that's the Iker Mitzvah. The next 79 is Hidr Mitzvah. L'kak La'achar She'ayluk, after the Baal HaBayis lights, v'nigmar ma'isad waka, shehi me'yikar adin, v'meila ein shayach yoter lahadir b'mitzvah. V'mishim kach b'er ha-rambam, the perish ner l'chol echa v'echad, hu shen madlik Baal HaBayis nerish b'shvi ha-kulam. The kevin is gulam ha-loko b'ma'isad waka, acha shayach b'zehidir. Acha rama, ho'lech l'shitason, but the rama, pasak, he goes like the tour, over there in the Gemara in Shabbos, a pasuk the Ramah paskins, but tzitzin she'ein ma'akvin amila, gedas hator de b'chol chozer aval tzitzin she'ein ma'akvin amila, v'al karcha sover the shayel gakayim hider mitzvah af liachar shenigma ma'isa mitzvah, v'akakos of a Ramah the chol echav ne'abayis yadlik gakayim b'ze hider mitzvah af liachar shenigma ma'isa mitzvah lakas Baal HaBayis. So therefore, the Briska Rav says, this machlokes is l'shitason. We discussed two disputes. One dispute is the Gemara in Shabbos, Kuf Lamed Gimel, regarding Sitzin HaMa'akvin and Sitzin She'ein HaMa'akvin. The Torah's opinion is on Shabbos, you don't go back because you can't be Machal Shabbos v'hid the mitzvah, but during Sunday you do go back. And Rambam writes, Ben Bechol, Ben B'Shabbos. So what's in the Kudus HaMachlokes? So the Briska Rav says, that it's, how do you view Hidda Mitzvah? Does Hidda Mitzvah make sense in a vacuum or only connected to the Ma'isa Mitzvah? So the Rambam says it's connected to the Ma'isa Mitzvah, and therefore, once you Nigmar Mitzvah, there's no point in doing a Hidda, there's no value. And the Torah says there is value, and you do it. So that's what the Briska Rav says, that's the issue here. Both the Rambam and the Ramah agree that we say Mahajim and the Mahadrin, there'd be 80 candles, according to Beis Hillel on the eighth night of Chanukah. The Machlokes, the Rambam and the Rama is, who lights them? The Rama writes, every person lights their own menorah, and therefore, that's how you get the 80. And the Rama holds, no. Every person, one person, the Baal HaBayis lights all. So, what's the issue? So, the Briska Rav says, the Rambam sheet is, only the one who's involved in the actual mitzvah itself could do the Hidr, so therefore the one who number one has to light the next 79. But the Ramah goes with the Torah, no, Hidr Mitzvah makes sense independently, and therefore each person could light their own menorah with their own bracha. We'll see if one has to learn this way. We'll have to get into that. Perhaps there, maybe even the Rama agrees. You don't make a bracha on hiddur mitzvah. Maybe it's no raya. It's a whole discussion. Do you make a bracha on hiddur mitzvah? Someone to bring a raya from the Rama. Maybe you could argue it's no raya. Number one is they don't have a mind to be yotze. They have a mind that they're going to fulfill the mitzvah on their own. That gets into another issue on what is the nature of the mitzvah of near Chanukah. We'll have to continue on whether it they call chovas habayis. It's like the mitzvah of mezuzah. It's an obligation that if you have a house, you have to light candles. It's like if you have a house, you have to put a mezuzah up. Well, no. Well, fundamentally, it's a chovas hagavra. It's a personal obligation, but the obligation is that I have to put it up in a house. So we'll have to get into it next time.